All right, guys, we're back in my garage, and in this video, we're just going to take a deeper look at the B58 intake manifold. So I'm in the middle of doing my port injection install, and I just thought that this would be a good time to kind of do an overview of what we're looking at and maybe just give you guys a little bit of insight in what's going on here, because I know with the air-to-water intercooler and all of those things, a lot of you are kind of curious about how all this works. So let me know if this is something that you're interested in seeing more of in the future. I might be able to get my hands on some other parts and just do like a deep dive so that we can understand the inner workings and how all this stuff works. All right, so starting off with the intake manifold, as you can see, we've got six intake ports. Each one has its own individual gasket. And inside of here, as you can tell, we have our air-to-water intercooler. So the way that this works is we actually have cold water coming into this inlet, and it flows through the front of the intake manifold and then cycles back through the back of the intake manifold and then comes out of this outlet. And so that helps give like a really nice gradient, because as air is coming through here, it's hot and it kind of hits warm coolant and then cooler coolant and then goes into the engine bay. So having the colder, fresh water at the front of the intercooler and then the warmer water at the back of the intercooler just helps kind of control how the air is cooled down before it gets into the cylinder head. So it's a very efficient core, very high quality system. I just kind of measured it to get like ballpark figures. I don't actually want to remove it since this is factory sealed and in good condition, but the measurements on the intercooler were around 200 cubic inches or close to like 3.25 liters. So if you look at comparable aftermarket air-to-water intercoolers, that puts us at around like maybe a 700 horsepower rating. I know you've seen people like me pushing over 600 to 700 horsepower without any IAT issues because the intake manifold is so efficient. So if we take a look at the side, this is how it's actually attached. So you can see where the water basically comes in, and it goes down into the core, and then on this side it comes out and then flows through this outlet pipe. These bolts can actually be removed and you can completely remove the core. Again, I'm not going to do that since I don't want to create any leaks or anything, have any issues with the gaskets in here. But I do remember there was a company that was actually planning on replacing this plastic with just a metal version, and then you reuse your intercooler. So if you're not really hell-bent on getting lower IATs, or you're like me, not really having IAT issues, but you just want a metal manifold to prevent you from running into potentially breaking it due to high boost, that would be kind of like a nice cheap option. So we'll see if that comes out in the future. I think some people scrapped that idea just because they didn't think people would buy it, but you know, time will tell. Now, if we look at the other side, this is pretty simple. We do have this kind of bleed hose on the top of the intake manifold, and the goal for that is if there is any air in here, it can basically bleed out through this hose and then it returns to your coolant reservoir. This is kind of like a design issue, because when you have a cooling system that needs to be completely bled from all air, you want the highest point in the system to be something that can vent. So that's why typically you have your coolant reservoir or whatever the highest point is, something that can basically have a cap that's removed. So while you're bleeding the system, air can, you know, rise up and then escape through that cap. So because this is the highest point, they've added this hose. And as you're going through the bleed cycle, air can come out through here. And then eventually this just is full of coolant and you'll see it squirting coolant back into the reservoir. We also have this MAP sensor up here. So this is your manifold pressure sensor. This also measures the temperature. So as you're basically getting hot air going over your intercooler and then coming out right before the cylinder head, you're going to be able to measure your IATs here. So this is the best representation of the actual air temperature before it goes into the engine. So if you're looking at charge temps, that's usually before the intercooler down by your charge pipe. And then this is where you're actually measuring your intake air temperature. I know some people were also curious about kind of how much space we have up here for like any meth nozzles or injectors, like if you literally just wanted to drill and tap into here. And the intercooler literally comes right up to this point. So to install any meth nozzles, there's really not a lot of space, and the cylinder head kind of has an overhang where the valve cover goes, so there's not a lot of space down here either. So that's why you don't really see a lot of people doing that. I know some of you maybe from other platforms have seen that before, but to work around this pressure sensor and just how much room we don't have here makes it a little less viable of an option. Now, as we come to this end, we have a little bit more emission stuff. So this is the hole where our evap hose comes in, and then you have another hose that comes out from this side. So basically you have two different channels for your evap to go, just like your PCV. If you're in boost, then it's going to skip this hole and basically route everything back to your intake because it's always going to be under vacuum. If you're not in boost, then the manifold is going to be seeing vacuum as well, so it will route your evap into here. And it's basically just gases from the fuel tank that are recirculating into the engine for emissions purposes. So really nothing that's too big of an issue. I mean, if you want to simplify it, in theory, you could completely delete your evap system and just have it vent to atmosphere, but it's not as critical as like your PCV system that's routing oil back to your intake tract. Now, lastly, what I want to do is take a look inside of our intake manifold. And basically what you see is that it tapers down really tight as it goes back towards cylinder six. And this is just the way that the factory had to do it because of our oil filter location. And you can even see down here, there's kind of a depression, right? So this is for our oil filter to be able to access that. So that's the only unfortunate thing I would say. I wish we had more volume here to help with the air distribution. That can also probably be a part of the reason why meth has trouble making it all the way back to cylinder six if you're only injecting from one point. But overall, I think the design is really good. Of course, the other thing that would be awesome is if this was completely made out of metal. With these ribs kind of going across the intake manifold, it makes it a little bit stronger, you know, just to kind of reinforce the plastic. But at these seams where it's actually just welded together, it can crack. I've seen a lot of people damage it at some of these points inside of here. So you just kind of got to be careful. Definitely do a smoke test if you feel like you're losing boost. Check around here, see if there's any damage, any pieces that are broken off, because it won't necessarily be super apparent all the time, but under higher boost levels, you might get leaks around some of these seams. So I think that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and hopefully this gives you a little more insight on what the intake manifold looks like and how it all works and what's underneath it and all of that good stuff. If you guys want to see anything else like this, let me know, and maybe I can try to get my hand on, you know, some used parts or broken parts or whatever, just to make some videos to dissect what's going on with our cars. So thank you guys for watching. I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do.